Hello everybody, I'm Christian with River Pools, and in today's video, we're gonna be talking about an issue that existed in the fiberglass pool and fiberglass boat industry until just a couple decades ago. We're gonna be talking about and showing you how osmotic blisters form in gel coat. So what I'm gonna show you today is how osmosis can form blisters in a gel coat finish on a pool. I'm also going to show you how fiberglass industry practices changed to prevent osmotic blisters. Lastly, I'll explain how you can tell if your fiberglass pool manufacturer is doing everything it should to prevent osmotic blisters. Osmosis is an intriguing biological process, and if you don't quite remember how it works, no need to run to Google. Here's the basics. Osmosis is the movement of water molecules through a semi-permeable surface from a solution of low concentration to a solution of higher concentration. Got it? Now keep this in the back of your mind as I show you osmosis in action. You see, gel coat is actually a semi-permeable surface. It's much like the paint in your house, on your walls. It provides a really good finish, however, it's not waterproof and certainly not so when under pressure.
Hold on to your seats, we're about to get a bit more technical.
Let's assume for a second that the membrane on the inside of an eggshell is much like the gel coat finish on your fiberglass pool. Now, for the sake of this experiment and demonstration, I've removed the outer shell, the hard outer shell of the egg, by soaking it in vinegar over a period of time. Okay, this is how it works. So I've placed the egg in a solution, in this case, water. But inside the egg is also a solution, and that solution contains solvents, proteins, minerals, vitamins, all the things that make eggs worthy of consumption for energy. And because there are more solvents on the inside of the egg as opposed to the outside, biology wants to try to correct this and balance things out. And so water is drawn into the egg through osmosis in an attempt to dilute the concentration of the solution inside the egg. So I know what you're thinking. You're asking yourself, how is this possible? How could this play into the gel coat finish of my fiberglass pool? I mean, I have a solution on one side of my gel coat, which is the pool water. But how could osmosis occur if the layer behind gel coat is solid? Like, that's not a solution of any concentration. You're correct. The next layer is solid, but what is that next layer made of? See, that's the question we need to get to the bottom of. You see, osmotic blisters were always a problem in the fiberglass pool and the boat industries. And that's because that second layer right behind the gel coat was always polyester resin. Now, remember earlier when I mentioned that gel coat is a semi-permeable membrane. Water has always gone through it and it always will. So it's a matter of keeping the water from the polyester, because what happens is when water comes in contact with that second layer, and if that second layer is polyester resin, a reaction occurs, and that reaction begins to break down the polyester resin. When that happens, a small void is formed, a cavity begins to build and grow right behind the gel coat, and as more water enters, the broken down material becomes suspended in that water, therefore creating a solution. Not just a solution though, a concentrated solution on the wrong side of the gel coat. And as more water enters, it pops that blister right out. There's your osmotic blister. So the trick is to prevent that by inserting a vinyl ester layer, which doesn't break down as readily when it comes in contact with water. Could it break down? Sure, but your pool water would have to be like vinegar or battery acid. And so what I'm telling you here is that even in the middle of winter, when your pool is shut down and the water is not balanced, that vinyl ester resin is still not going to react with the water, and it's still going to protect the polyester layers from coming in contact with pool water. Your pool will be protected from osmotic blisters. So you might be asking, should the entire pool be built using vinyl ester resin? The short answer is no. You see, it's not a matter of how many layers of vinyl ester resin are used, it's a matter of how good the one layer is. You should know that there are different quality grades or blends available. In fact, a resin with just 1% vinyl ester in it could still be called a vinyl ester resin. Yeah, When it comes to vinyl ester resin, the blend would have to be at least 50% to have any effectiveness at all against reacting when it comes in contact with water. And even then, the effectiveness is pretty marginal. Which is why at River Pools, we use a 100% vinyl ester resin, because we know that many layers of a lower quality vinyl ester resin are not better than one properly installed layer of the highest quality vinyl ester resin. So when shopping for a fiberglass pool, how do you know if the manufacturer is using 100% vinyl ester resin? Well, check out the warranty and ask, does it specifically cover the gel coat finish in the event that osmotic blisters form? There are no smoke and mirrors here at River Pools. We are confident in the materials used and the tried and true fiberglass construction processes used. So much so that we back your pool with a 15-year surface warranty protecting your gel coat finish against osmotic blisters. Again, if your pool gets osmotic blisters, we have you covered. And furthermore, we invite you down to see the shop to meet the people that build your pool and ask any question you would like. We are confident in our processes, we're confident in our products, and we stand behind you, the customer. Okay, we've covered a lot today, but remember, osmosis equals blisters. 100% vinyl ester resin prevents osmosis. And if your pool has a gel coat surface warranty, then that means you are protected with 100% vinyl ester resin. So if this video was helpful for you, and I hope that it was, give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for the next episode when we talk about how polyester resin is used to build the third layer of your pool. I'm Christian with River Pools. We'll see you next time. Catch the wave.